It happens here, Webster. Founded in 1832 by Samuel Slater and named after Daniel Webster, and home to Clara Barton. Safe to say, American history runs deep in this town. So why does the lake get all of the attention? Welcome to Webster Lake, also known as
Lake Cha Gaga Gag Montraga Gacha Buna Gugamon.
Here, the children are taught to sing it.
Lake Chicago Gog, Man Chaga Gog, Shabana Ganga Mog.
And Websterites let it roll off the tongue.
Lake Chagagog, Man Chagagog, Shabanagog.
Chagagog, Man Chagagog, Shabangagangamog.
Chagagog, Man Chagagog, Shabanagangamog.
Yeah, try saying that 10 times fast. But how did Webster Lake's full name end up the longest in the United States? We stopped by local staple Point Breeze for the beautiful view and a breakdown of the history with Paul Masick, author of Early History of Webster, Dudley, and Oxford.
The lake has meant a great deal for Native Americans, especially the Nipmuc Indians who lived around the lake.
In 1668, John Eliot, a proclaimed apostle to the Indians, came to Webster to set up praying villages, but also to play name games with the lake.
And he gave the lake certain names like Manchagagog. He also used Chabanagungamog.
As time went on and the town headed towards incorporation, the name of the lake had to finally be decided on. And in 1831, a local surveyor took matters into his own hands.
He put down three names. He put down Chagagagog, and then he put down Manchagagog, and then he put down Chabanagungamog. So
he's like, it's one of these three. I don't,
it is.
I don't know. And the longest named place in the United States was born. So what does it mean? The most popular translation is, you fish on your side, I fish on my side, and nobody fishes in the middle. But Carla Manzi, a lifelong Websterite, tells us that's not exactly true.
That was made up by a newspaper publisher of the Webster Times back in the 1920s, who was writing a story, and it took off. And later on, he came and said, you know, I just made that up, so really don't use that.
The real meaning translates to fishing place at the boundaries.
Or neutral fishing place.
So a place where everyone can come and fish. In essence, Webster Lake has stayed just that, a place where people can come together.
Webster Lake was always been a big part of the town. It provides a big sense of pride for the community.
I guess the lake means different things to different people, but it's the jewel of Webster. It certainly is.
So whether you can say it,
Lake Chagagagog, Man Chagagog, Chabanagungamog.
Spell it.
Chagagagagmanchagagogchagagagmanchagagungamog.
Or just taking it one section at a time.
Chagagagog, Man Chagagog, Chabanagungamog.
There's no denying Webster Lake is the perfect place for family and friends to meet and to find a special meaning all their own.